This program has been interrupted for a party political broadcast on behalf of the Peace Party. Peace Party. Educate peace. Thank you.
We realize that there are corruptions among the, you know, the police and the drug users itself has become the biggest obstacle of all. So we will establish an anti-drug task force, and we carefully recruitment of police officers, and we have punishment of corrupt officers as well.
But thank you to tell us what exactly programs you are talking about. That's specific. I mean, we need concrete programs. Not just mentioning that, hey, we're going to have a program, we're going to expose problems. So
let us not make the life stagnant in that vision. Ladies and gentlemen, they are youth. They are the hope of our nation. Let us help them, let us develop them, because they will become the leaders of this nation.
The task force you mentioned in your fancy, is that as well as it? So you're going to be having a task force and implementing the police as well.
But then, other parties that you said we will rehabilitate, how will we rehabilitate? Because he, like, come up with examples.
Okay, legitimate question. So, how?
What exactly is the problem? You know that it's drugs, but do you know what you're fighting? And do you know how you're going to fight it? How can you attack a problem without knowing where it is, why it happens, and who is doing it? So, I want to know what the other parties have to say about it.
You're thinking. Your emotions, anything that you take in is drugs. The problem there, do I have to specify every problem, Mr. Speaker?
That's the question.
Okay, if I'm going to elaborate it, then, okay, the problem, the drug addiction causes your thinking to, yes, Mr. Speaker?
I'm not asking about what drugs does to you, but I'm asking about what is the problem, why are people taking it, who is taking it, and you know where they are.
Okay. And the second part of the debate is crime and punishment. The structure will be the same. You'll hear 2-minute policy speeches from each of the individual ministers, and then we'll open it up to questions from the floor. Okay, we're ready. I would like to start.
Territorialism at a very young age, and fighting, not fighting, but
can I ask them, how does this complement both the 10 points that they are taking? Thank you so much.
An eye for an eye. If you're going to take a life, you violated their human rights. But the person you murdered may not have done anything wrong, so should the person not.
So everybody gets a due process of law. However, those who are drug trafficking, like shipping millions of tons of drugs into our country, rapists, murderers, will be met with death sentence.
Here, it may be argued that we are actually violating the rights of the offender by providing for capital punishment. But our position is that the rights of the society should outweigh the rights of an offender who has committed heinous crimes, such as rapes and murders.
But what about the innocent people? Are you going to strike fear with those people as well?
I think the innocent people.
There should always be a way of negotiation between the ruling party and also the secessionists. This is for the peace and harmony of the nation. So we would always be open for negotiation and talk.
It's a basic human right to love your life without fear. And for what? And for that, he's not going. When we are elected, we will implement clear laws, clear punishment, and rehabilitation for all. We believe that everybody knows the difference between right and wrong.
We will conduct campaigns, instructing or giving instructions, details about the crimes that they will commit with the method of sentence of punishment and the side effects, the bad effects of committing crime, and also what they will be able to get if ever they would avoid it from the government.
One of the main problems is committing violent crimes. AFL, we believe very strongly that
The actual people in your prisons, your own thoughts and feelings of who these people are.
How do you say that?
We have to diversify. We have to educate. We agree in fighting terrorism, but not through the use of war. We have to educate, educate, and educate more. We have to let the people know that crime does not pay. We have to create bilateral agreements between the parties. We have to encourage dialogue. We have to encourage talks between the two parties. Thirdly, we have to exhaust all possible peace-building efforts.
This is a whole new government. We're changing not only from martial law to democracy, but we're changing a lot of the ideals, and we're trying to eradicate a lot of the negative things that came with our last government. Our country, the name of our country, is Infalida. It's a combination of four different cultures. It is very easy for other cultures, for other countries, to not understand what is going on with our country, to not understand that there can be bits of unity within a multicultural society. And that's all there is.